Hello, this is Solar PVTV from World Future Energy Summit for Solar PVTV, but also UFS TV. And now we have a pleasure to speak to Michele Scandellari, who is CEO of NRA. Actually, we spoke with him a couple of weeks ago about the Falcon project, 23.1 project, one of the first utility scale projects, solar projects in Jordan. Here we have also guys from Jordan in the audience. So, you know, if you have some projects, you can come to Michele. But today we will, also I forgot to say that this is the guy whose company is building the largest projects now in Latin America, 354 megawatts in total in Latin America. Very soon will be open. Great experience, international experience, company from Italy, member of the McAfee Group.
NRA, as Thomas said, is part of McAfee Group, which is a privately owned industrial group based in Italy. The first company of the group has been founded in 1879. As NRA, we are active in the solar business since 2007. Nowadays, we are active in 13 countries, meaning that in 13 countries, we have direct presence throughout the company, while we are using some of this company as an hub. For instance, in the Middle East, we have companies Morocco, Jordan, KSA in Egypt, and through these companies, we're following all the areas, while in the Americas, we have a direct presence in Mexico, Brazil, and Costa Rica, and we are using Mexico and Costa Rica to pivot our role in all Central Americas. Then we do have a presence in Bangkok to cover Thailand market and surrounding countries.
We are here, Michele, to focus more on the Middle East, and especially on your Moroccan project, because it seems to be quite innovative, yes?
Yeah, for sure. Basically, in Morocco, we won two tenders. One is an EPC contract in which we are finishing. It's going to be connected by March, a 1 megawatt pilot project on CSP based on Fresnel technology. Basically, there are mirrors that are concentrated solar power, then is going to go in a fluid, and then the fluid can storage the thermoelectricity. This has been quite challenging for us because it's been a new philosophy of plants in a new market for us. Then we won together with ENEA, which is Italian National Research Agency, an European tender for an innovative storage system, which will be based basically on magnetite. So we are going to build a storage based on a mineral stone to conserve the heat produced by the plant.
Because it's a very interesting topic, actually, because we are speaking a lot also about the storing the energy, yes, not only producing. And do you see, you know, advantage of this solution also for the other countries in the region? And do you have any plans, you know, how you'd like to scale up these projects? Or this is only, let's say, on the small scale, and you are not having yet the strategy how to go to different markets? So what is your strategy, actually?
We do believe in the technology. We are currently not knowing if it's going to be applied on a small scale, on a large utility scale, because still CSP has a price gap compared to other technology quite significant. For sure, this technology is born for this latitude. I mean, it's working with really, really a lot of sun. To give you an example, in Italy, it's only applicable in Sicily, which is quite close to Tunisia. So in the north, is impossible. We are doing quite significant experience. It's challenging because, as you know, probably one of the biggest advantage of PV that is quite simple technology-based, while CSP is a really a complex power facility.
And you were saying about the cost advantage, yes, of the technology, but recently we heard, especially here in the region, about such low prices of solar PV, yes?
Yeah, for sure there's going to be probably rooms. For sure they can decrease significantly the price because the market is still too limited. So the cost of production for manufacturing is still quite high. I can foresee a couple of potential threats to this technology. The first one is a battery. I mean, if the the traditional battery or traditional battery applied to solar will be available, I do believe that is still not a cost, is still not a question of cost, but is more a question of reliable of technology on the medium term. This is going to be a big threat to CSP. The other one is that probably in some areas like Morocco, you can use it. Probably Jordan, you can use it. In other areas like KSA, where a liter of water is costly 10 times a liter of gasoline, probably using water to clean the mirror, it's going to be quite expensive.
And because you are CEO of the company, so you are, let's say, having the overview of the long-term strategy of the company. So which place, let's say, in terms of percentage for this technology you see in your overall solar business?
Oh, I do believe not more than 10%.
Not 10? Because you maybe will be doing dozens of gigawatts, yeah?
Hopefully.
So, you came yesterday here, but already I saw it was, your booth was quite busy. From your perspective, if you compare to the previous shows and last years in the MENA region, do you see that this market is really like kicking off now?
Yeah, absolutely. I do believe that Middle East now is ready to go. Thanks also, for instance, to some example in Morocco and Jordan that provided that the plants are real, they are constructed and connected to the grid. So I do believe that the general perception of Middle East is changing. Of course, in some cases, will take time, but for instance, we are in within the Egyptian first round project. We are still waiting some green light from the government, but yes, for sure. I mean, it's especially here, it's cheaper, and it makes sense at the actual price also for oil producing country.
So NRA is also supporter of today's event. So it's World Solar and Cleantech Influencers Forum, during which we would like to unite industry, political decision makers, investors, and also the society. And do you believe that it's important to unite all the players in order to lead the clean disruption, the exponential growth?
Yeah, I do believe it's in some ways fundamental. I mean, what is sometimes bizarre about renewable is that apparently we are not learning from past mistakes. And as European, we did a lot of mistakes. No, we created the biggest market, and then we basically killed the same biggest market. Solar for us, that we are acting as an EPC contractor, so we are not producing any technology. It's challenging and vulnerable markets, meaning that my business is quite scalable, so I need usually to partner with someone else. And if you're looking in Middle East, and with the writing is completely different, the language is completely different. Probably with some part of Middle East, we do have a common history on the Mediterranean, but that's it. We do believe that partnering is a key issue to succeed.
Thank you so much. That was Solar PVTV from World Future Energy Summit, together with CEO of NRA, Michele Scandalari, and the crowd of future partners of NRA in the region. Thanks for watching.